Hi everyone, welcome back to exercise 9.4 integral calculus question number 30. Integrate. So before integration, I will write like this only. Integrate 1 by root under ax plus b minus ax plus c, with respect to x, so write here dx. Is equal to integral 1 by root under ax plus b minus ax plus c, and then multiply with the conjugates numerator and that is root ax plus b, and there is a minus right here plus, and then this part ax plus c. And downside divide with same parts. Ax plus b plus ax plus c dx. Okay. This is just the conjugate multiple, because this is equal to 1 only. If I cancel up and down, this is 1. So multiplying any number with 1 doesn't affect. Okay. So we have just taken this part. Note this is minus, so there is plus and plus. Okay. Is equal to integral 1 into this part is equal to same ax plus b plus ax plus c, and then this is of the form a minus b into a plus b. We have formula a minus b into a plus b is equal to b is equal to a square minus b square. So it means what? This is root ax plus b whole square minus root ax plus c whole square is equal to what? Ax plus b, because this 2 and this root cancel. Now minus, and now there is minus, so give the bracket, and ax plus c. Why? Because this 2 and this root cancel. Now if I solve this part, this is ax plus b and minus this ax, and then minus plus minus c. So this ax is cancel, and b minus c, this is what? B minus c. So now in place of this part, this total part here, you can write here b minus c, and now dx. So here you can see this b minus c is the constant, so you can write it outside this integral. So write here 1 by b minus c outside, and now this integral will be here integral, and this is called what? Ax plus b. This means what? Ax plus b, root under means what? Ax plus b to the power 1 by 2, So you can write here this power 1 by 2, and then this dx plus integral ax plus b to the power 1 by 2. Yes, this power 1 by 2 you can write here. And now dx is equal to 1 by b minus c. Now integral of this part is equal to what? As it is ax plus b 1 by 2 and then add plus 1. And here same you have to write here 1 by 2 plus 1. But we should also divide this part, by this coefficient of x, that is a. We have to divide here a. Because we have formula. If there is ax plus b to the power n, then we have to write dx, integral. Then we have to write here ax plus b to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. And then this coefficient of f should write here a, or 1 by a, this is your formula. So we have done now here. Now this part, this now plus ax plus b to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 and then 1 by 2 plus 1 and then divide with this coefficient of f, that is a. We'll let see, okay, finally we'll let see, okay. Now, one by two plus one. 1 by 2 plus 1 is equal to what? 1 by 2 plus 1 means 1 by 1 is equal to 2 is LCM. So 2 ones are 2 and then 1 ones are 1. So plus 1. This is equal to what? 3 by 2. So in place of this you can write 3 by 2. So 1 by B minus C as it is. And this is AX plus B to the power is 3 by 2. And here this A into 3 by 2 plus AX plus B to the power 3 by 2 and then this A into 3 by 2. Is equal to 2, okay. And now you can write this line, okay, this line here, and there is something means there is 1, okay, and there is what is there? A into 3 by 2. So how you can write this part? This is equal to 1 by 3a, okay, 3a by 2. And now this will be written as 2 by 3a, okay, 2 by 3a, because first and last will go upside and then 3a. So this is 2 by 3a you can write here in place of this. So 1 by b minus c, but this is what? This part is equal to, when it goes upside it will be what? 2a by 3a and else 2a by 3a. So it will, I'll take it outside. So outside means what? 2 by 3a outside. And remaining part, this is our remaining part. Ax plus b to the power 3 by 2 plus ax plus b to the power 3 by 2. Now, this is equal to, you can write here, 2 into 1, 2, and then 3a into b minus c, okay? And then ax plus b to the power 3 by 2 plus ax plus b to the power 3 by 2 plus constant c finally, okay? So this is our answer. Thank you. See you again. Bye.